हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंत फ्रॉम डीजे इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 32। गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया लॉन्च्ड ए मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन मेरा रेशन, विच रेशन कार्ड होल्डर्स पर्टिकुलरली माइग्रेंट बेनिफिशियर्स कैन यूज फॉर आइडेंटिफाइंग द नियरेस्ट फेयर प्राइस शॉप, चेक डिटेल्स ऑफ देयर एंटाइटलमेंट एंड रीसेंट ट्रांजैक्शन। द एंड्रॉयड मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन डेवलप्ड बाय नेशनल इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स सेंटर इज करेंटली इन हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश। ग्रेजुअली इट वुड बी मेड अवेलेबल इन 14 मोर लैंग्वेजेस। Over 30,000 sellers across India have registered on the vendor onboarding mobile app launched by CAIT on Thursday for its upcoming e-commerce portal Bharat eMarket. CAIT President B.C. Bharatiya said such a rousing response to Bharat eMarket proves that foreign multinational e-commerce giants operating in India were not giving a fair opportunity for Indian sellers to thrive. Ahead of assembly elections in four states and a union territory, a startup firm has unveiled a mobile application with poll statistics and the data on the country's economy to help voters take fact-based decisions before exercising their franchise. The startup Democratica launched the application Bol Subol, which has an economic and political information about all the constituency in India over 60 years on average. Indian Space Research Organization launched the sounding rocket RH-560 to study attitudinal variations in the neutral winds and plasma dynamics carried out on Friday at Satish Dhawan Space Center, Sriharikota Range. WhatsApp head Bill Cathcart may not have anything to do with Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey, but when it comes to India, he is worried not only about the Union government aims to break encryption, but also the move to promote the homegrown microblogging platform Kuu. Realme has been teasing its 8 series for a while now. Already company has been confirmed its launch date. The company dropped a video earlier today teasing the March 24th unveiling the Realme 8 lineup. Qualcomm is struggling to keep up with demands for its processor chip used in smartphones and gadgets, as chip shortage that first hit the auto industry spread across the electronic business. Samsung Electronics Co. Limited, the world's largest smartphone maker, is experiencing a shortage of Qualcomm application processor, the heart of smartphones two people at suppliers for the South Korean giant told to Reuters. Oppo is reportedly working on two new A-series phones called Oppo A94 5G and Oppo A54 5G. The former handset seems to be 5G model of the already launched Oppo A94. The 4G model went officially in UAE just few days ago. Now a new leak suggests that it could be a 5G model maybe in this offering too. Tesla chief executive Elon Musk has been sued by a shareholder who accused him by violating his 2018 settlement with the US Securities and Exchange Commission over the Twitter use. The complaint highlighted several Musk posts on social media platform Twitter, including his assessment last May 1st, that Tesla's stock price was too high, promoting a more than $13 billion tumble in Tesla's market value. Software and cloud computing giant Microsoft is going to roll out a new feature to video chatting platform Teams that will help in attending calls in case you have a poor internet connectivity. The company is working on adding a low bandwidth mode to facilitate calls even if users have access to slow internet. The company confirmed this through its Microsoft 365 road plan. A Japanese-Australian venture has begun producing hydrogen from brown coal in a $500 million Australian dollar pilot project that aims to show liquefied hydrogen can be produced commercially and exported safely overseas. The plan is to create the first liquefied hydrogen, and the next big step will be to ship a cargo on the world's first liquefied hydrogen carrier. One Bitcoin has crossed more than $60,000, that is roughly around 43.7 lakhs for the first time on Saturday. As increasing backing from the corporate companies helps the world's most popular virtual currency continue its record-breaking run. Amazon has infused over 225 crores into its payment units in India on Amazon Pay. According to the regulatory documents, the fresh infusion is expected to help the company compete more aggressively against rivals like PhonePe, Google Pay and Paytm. Apple has sued a former MacBook designer, Simon Lancaster, a veteran product design architect, for illegally selling a trade secrets and details about unreleased products to a tech journalist. A piece of digital art, or what is known as non-fungible token, has sold for $69 million. The digital artwork by American artist Mike Mickelvan, better known by his artist name Beeple, was auctioned by Christie's at a standalone online auction, which took place from Feb 25th to March 11th. The work of the art in question is titled Winkleman's Everydays. The first 500 days, the artwork is a collage of digital images which Beeple has taken every day since 2007 from a total of 5,000 days tried. The artwork was listed to an unknown piece of Christie's through Beeple has pegged its value at $100. Shankara High Foundation and Singapore-based Leban Care are deploying Retina Risk Assessment SaaS platform in India, Netra AI. The cloud-based artificial intelligence solution is powered by Intel technology and it is claimed to be using deep learning to identify retinal condition in a short span of time with the accuracy level of human doctors. The solution can help to identify diabetic retinopathy, reducing the screening burden of vitreoretinal surgeons. COVID vaccination drive in India is underway. As one of the largest vaccination drive continues, it becomes crucial to take proactive steps to provide timely, accurate and science-based information about the vaccines. This becomes crucial as misinformation and disinformation about the vaccine can undermine its overall efficacy. Google Search is one of the crucial platforms that can help against spreading lies about the vaccine. The company says that it is working with the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation to disseminate science-based narrative around vaccination drive. When a group of IBM Indian employees, including data scientists and communication experts, volunteered to work on a tech solution that could help students learn the English language. The challenge was to figure out what the solution would be. After months of brainstorming sessions, the team started working on a professor idiom, an AI-powered chatbot developed from Abhida Foundation, an NGO based in Kolkata. Social networking giant Facebook has announced that it is going to expand which content creators will be able to post ads on its platform, which essentially means users are going to see a lot more ads more than previously. Facebook ad monetization said that Facebook is now going to allow content creators to earn revenue through stories. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.